Good morning everyone, this is Miss Nafisa, welcome you all to Google Classroom. This is the first day of English first paper. I hope you have enjoyed the other classes. So I'm hoping that you will also enjoy my class. I hope everyone is fine. I thought to discuss dialogue writing part to discuss here, because the other categories from writing part are discussed in the class, so dialogue writing wasn't touched that way, so that's why I have thought to discuss it here. From class 6 you are practicing dialogue writing, and class 7 also you are practicing the same, but what I have seen, many of you have the problems like earlier to write an effective dialogue or to write the dialogue fruitful. So today I'll discuss the first dialogue from your syllabus, that is write a dialogue with your friend for lending a book for 2 days. So many of you have a kind of thinking that dialogue is easy, we do not have to practice it much, or we do not have to pay more attention on it. But what I have seen from my last experience that whenever you write dialogue, you fail to meet your expectation, you do not write proper conversation the way it should be, or you just memorize the book's conversation and produce the same in the on the copy. But dialogue is not that way. Dialogue is some, you know, the dialogue is a conversation that has to be more lively, as if you are talking to your friend face to face. Okay, so we have to write dialogue in such a way. So today we will discuss the dialogue writing number 1, and you know that we have to write 10 pairs for writing each dialogue, and mark is also 10. So this is dialogue number 1, that is write a dialogue with your friend for lending a book for 2 days. And as the dialogue is about with your friend and no particular name is mentioned here, so I have given 2 imaginary names, one is Mac and another is Jack. You can name your friends, or you can name your own the way you want. So this is the Mac, and I have started dialogue with Mac. Here is another important thing, that if you look very properly on the title or topic, you will see that it is for lending a book for 2 days. Okay, so there is a catch, that this is for lending, okay, not borrowing. There's a difference between to borrow a book and lend a book. To borrow a book means you are taking a book from your friend for some times or for some days, and for lending a book means you are giving your book to your friend for some days or for some times. So you have to understand that here your friend is taking a book from you, not you are taking a book from your friend. So Mac is your friend and you are Jack here. Okay, that means writer is Jack here and the friend is Mac. So I have started the dialogue with Mac. Okay, and I have created a scenario that Mac has come to Jack's house for taking the book, because as Mac needs the book, so he has come here, come to Jack's house for taking the book. So the first dialogue starts with Mac that, hey Jack. And Jack is replying, hello, what a pleasant surprise. Okay, so this is kind of sentence you can write, okay, rather than just write hello and hi, how are you. These are too traditional, okay. As writing part is something creative and you have to apply something, you have to write something from your own. That's why this kind of sentence creates some different impression. Okay, as Jack did not expect Mac, that's why this type of sentence you can produce on your copy. That was, what a pleasant surprise. Mac, how are you? And Jack is replying that, I'm good. What about you? you have remained absent in school for few days. Okay, now you can understand that why Jack was unexpected and why Jack has become surprised to see Mac, because Mac was absent for a few days in the school. And Mac is replying here, I'm quite okay now. I had fever for last few days. That's why I could not attend school. So this is the reason. It's clear Mac is replying or clearing his issue of being absent in the school. He had a high fever. That's why he could not attend the school. Now Jack is replying, oh, I see. I hope you can attend school from Sunday. So Jack has understood that, and he is hoping that his friend is going to start or going to attend his school from Sunday. Mac, sure, even I'll have to recover my classes by attending extra class. So from this line you can understand that how sincere Mac is, okay, how good student Mac is, okay, because he is feeling his loss that he could not attend the school. He has missed the important classes, so that's why he is saying that obviously I'll attend my school and I'll have to recover my class by attending extra class. Jack, that's really wonderful. Now Jack is appreciating Mac's thinking that he will have extra class. Mac, I have to come to you for taking science book for Friday and Saturday. Now Mac has come to the real point that why has he come to Jack's house. He has come to Jack's house for taking Jack's science book for Friday and Saturday. In the topic, we have seen that the friend is taking or lending the book for 2 days. So that's why the Friday and Saturday are mentioned here. Jack, sure, why not? May I know the reason, please? So Jack will give his book. That is, there is no doubt. But Jack is trying to know the reason why Mac is needed the book. Mac, obviously, actually for my sickness, I have missed my science CAT, which I need to attend on Sunday. So that's why Mac has to attend the science CAT, which he has missed. So as he will attend the CAT, so he has come to take Jack's house to take the Jack's book. Jack, yeah, we all have attended it. But how will you attend the test again? So Jack is telling that as Jack was present in the school, so along with other students, Jack has also attended the test, science test. So now as Mac was absent, so he has to attend the test. So that's why Jack is trying to know that how will you attend the test again, because other students have already done it. Mac, I have talked to Miss. She will retest it from E. So Mac is telling that that means he has talked to Miss, Science Miss, and she ensured that she will test it again. Jack, that sounds really good. That means Jack is feeling good that Mac can give the test. Mac, can I get your book, please? Jack, sure, why not? Anything else you need? Now Jack is trying to confirm that along rather than the book, Mac needs anything else or not. Mac, yeah, I need your science practical copy too. So along with the science book, Mac needs Jack's science practical copy also. Jack, wait for a while, let me bring. Mac, sure. Jack, here are my book and copy. So Jack has brought both of them. Mac, I'll give your book and copy back on Sunday. Jack, no worries, take your time. Mac, thanks a lot, dear. Jack, welcome, dear. Mac, see you soon on Sunday. Jack, good luck for your test. Bye. So you can see we have written more than 10 pairs. Okay, if you count, here are 12 to 13 pairs. I haven't counted. So here are more than 10 pairs. If you want to write exactly 10 pairs, you can cut some pairs or you can skip some pairs if you want. So which pair you will skip, you have to understand. Okay, you cannot skip the pair which is important or relevant to the topic. Okay, so by going through the topic or by going through the dialogue, you have to understand Or you may write the full dialogue, because I have told always in the class that the dialogue has to be at least 10 pairs. Okay, you can write 12 to 13 pairs. So this is the dialogue I have prepared from my own, and I haven't copied from anywhere else like you do. So this is the dialogue, and while going through the dialogue you can understand that this is a very lively, as if you are talking to your friend sitting side by side or face to face. So the dialogue has to be like that. This is totally on the topic, no extra information are given. Okay, after coming to Jack's house, Mac has cleared why he has come and what does he need. Okay, and for how many days he need the book, and he needs the book and copies. So when he will return those, everything is clear here. Okay, so this kind of dialogue has to be produced from you. That has to be really creative, really effective. And I want all of you to practice this kind of dialogue so that you can get write properly and also get proper marks. So that's all for today. I'm not discussing it anymore. And I want all of you to write the dialogue in a different way. I have shown you a way how to write a dialogue, or on this topic you can write the same dialogue by producing the lines, the information from your own. Thank you.